Andrew Farrow has posted a really cool question on our Facebook page, which is how to paint transonic blades carried by Sicarian Ruststalkers. To do this, first of all, you need to paint the blade using Cantor Blue and then darken it down using Null Oil. After that, you need to paint the effect on, starting with Sotek Green, followed by Fenrisian Grey, and finally a very small amount of White Scar. But we need to start out with our base coat of Cantor Blue, and I'm going to apply this using my medium layer brush. And what you want to do here is achieve a really smooth finish to it, so you really must use some water here to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. And once it's about like that, all you've got to do is base coat the entirety of the blade by applying two thin coats. Once that's done, we're now ready to darken down the blade by applying Null Oil. Now I'm actually going to apply two coats here, and the second one's slightly different from the first because I want the blade to be darker towards the tip. So the second coat is going to be applied from about this point onwards. Just be sure the first coat's completely dry before you add the second. Once the shade's completely dry, we're ready to start building the effect. And for this, we need Sotek Green first of all. And what you do is paint a series of vertical lines very close together towards the base of the blade like this, gradually spacing them out further and further apart as you get to the circles. And then when you get past the circles, have them very rarely. And you want them running across the entirety of the blade. Now, once you've achieved this, all you need to do is edge highlight the sword, including down the very center of it as well. Once you've done that, you're ready to build on the effect using Fenrisian Grey. And what you do with this is just do a smaller line focused on the centre of each of these parts on the blade. So just very lightly there like that. Then once you've done this on all these lines, what you need to do is another edge highlight all the way around and down the central line as well. Then finish off the effect by applying some white scar. You don't need very much of this, just little dots wherever these lines cross the centre of the blade, just there like that. And also where they meet the ends of the blade as well, such as just up here. And with that, the transonic blade is complete. And doing this really is all about keeping your hands steady. So remember, just brace your hands right down on the table if you need to avoid having any shakes. But Andrew, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.